Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about the formation of female gametophyte through the process of megasporogenesis. As in earlier video we have seen about the microsporogenesis, so in this video see, so the pistil megasporangium means ovule and formation of embryo sac. So as you know that female reproductive organs of the flowers are carpels and carpels collectively called as gynoecium. And a flower may have a single carpel. When there is a single carpel, then it is called as monocarpellary, as you have studied in class 11th. Two carpels, bicarpellary, and if several carpels, then it is multicarpellary. Or also known as polycarpellary. And the second most important thing that when more than one, the carpel may be free or fused. So when the carpels are free carpels, then it is the known as apocarpous condition. And when it is fused, it is known as syncarpous condition. I think you all have studied in class 11th what is the meaning of free carpel and fused carpels. So this is known as apocarpous and this one is known as syncarpous condition. And free unit of gynoecium is called as pistil, as we use interchangeably pistil and carpel. And you know each pistil has three parts. So what are the parts? Obviously stigma, style, and ovary. Stigma, style, and ovary. You can see here, this is stigma, style, long style, and ovary. This is the type of syncarpous ovary. See here, stigma, syncarpous ovary, and these are the free petals. So syncarpous pistil with free stigma of hibiscus, and B, multicarpellary syncarpous pistil of papaver, and C, multicarpellary apocarpous pistil of mycelia. So this is hibiscus, this is papaver, and this one is mycelia. So come to the next point, that formation of female gametophyte through the process of megasporogenesis. So it is a process of formation of haploid megaspores through haploid megaspores from diploid MMC, that is megaspore mother cells. Generally, a single megaspore mother cell differentiate in the micropylar region of nucleus, and it is distinct from other because it is having much of dense cytoplasm, prominent nucleus, larger size, and undergoes meiosis to form 4 haploid megaspores. See here in this diagram. This is primary archisporial cells, this is primary parietal cells, and primary sporogenous cells. So these are the megaspore mother cells which divide and form 4 haploid megaspores, which are arranged in linear tetrad, and this undergo meiosis and form 4 haploid megaspore, which is arranged in linear tetrad, and only one is functional. See here. In microsporogenesis, you have seen that all the 4 microspores were functional, but in megaspore sporogenesis, only one megaspore is functional and 3 will be degenerated. So, and this which is functional, it is full of cytoplasm, dense cytoplasm, prominent nucleus, and larger in size. And so this functional megaspore will behave as a first cell of female gametophyte. This will behave as a first cell of female gametophyte. And the functional megaspore is generally chalazal one, but is in some cases it is it can be at the micropylar end. And the non-functional megaspore will be degenerate. So in formation of female gametophyte or embryo sac, it generally develops from a single megaspore. Therefore, it is also called as monosporic. And the this functional megaspore, it grows in size. It undergoes 3 free nuclear mitotic division. Point to be noted that 3 free nuclear mitotic division. So what does it mean? So initially the megaspore nucleus divides mitotically into 2. See here. The 2 nuclei move to opposite poles, forming 2 nuclear stages of embryo sac. See here. It divides mitotically and come at the extreme ends. And this is called as 2 nuclear stages of embryo sac. But the nuclei undergo 2 sequential mitotic division and producing 4 nucleate stages. See here. And then 8 nucleate stages. See here. Of embryo sac. Then 2 groups of 4 nuclei is developed in 2 halves. See here. They developed into 2 halves. One nucleus from each group passes towards the center. See here, there are 4 nuclei and there are 3. They come to at the end point, and one from each group nuclei come at the center point. So and they are called as polar nuclei. They are called as polar nuclei. Soon cell walls are laid down. See, there is a start of formation of cell walls occur. And then both the nuclei, it comes at the center and seven cells are formed. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So seven cells are formed, but there is 8 nuclei. And you can see here that 3 egg apparatus at the micropylar end, and this is secondary nucleus which has 2 nuclei, and these are the antipodal cells. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So there are 7 celled but 8 nucleate stage, because 1 nucleus, 2 nucleus, 3 nucleus, 4 nucleus, 5 nucleus, 6 nucleus, 7 and 8. It has 2 nuclei. So ultimately it forms 7 celled and 8 nucleate stage. And this type of embryo sac is called as monosporic and polygonum type. You can see here in this also, this is primary archisporial cell, primary parietal cells, primary sporogenous cells, megaspore divides by meiosis, degenerative megaspore, functional megaspore. Then you can see it get degenerated, it become larger in size, dense cytoplasm, and these are the polar nuclei. First it divides mitotically, then again 2, 4, 8, then 3 here and 3 here, and one from each come at the center. And you can see here, this is egg apparatus, secondary nucleus and antipodal cells. So this is all about the, and finally you can see here that this types of embryo sac is formed. This is a structure of a typical embryo sac. This is a filiform apparatus. These are the synergids, egg, polar nuclei, central cell and antipodals. So what are the function of these? I will let you know in the next video.